Greetings and welcome to episode number 6. This episode will cover all the basics you need to know in order to unwrap UVW, your first model, and make it ready to be textured. Alright, so what does Unwrap UVW stand for and what does it mean? Well, I'm not going to go into greatest detail because it's quite a large topic and can be discussed for a long period of time. I will make a long video in the future discussing everything there is to unwrapping your models. To shorten it all down, Unwrap UVW can be compared to unwrapping a Christmas present very nicely. What I mean with that is, if you were to take all the wrapping paper around the present and lay it out nicely on the floor, so that there are no tearing, no wrinkles, no fold edges, that is sort of Unwrap UVW. It could also be good to know that the letters UVW can be compared to the X, Y, and Z. Now, Unwrap UVW may be a bit more technical than you may think. You have to actually think before you unwrap your model because you want to figure out what of the model is going to be using this texture and can I overlap the faces? Can I do this or can I do that? So I'm going to go ahead and talk a bit about the two possibilities of how we can unwrap our model. So at this point right now, we need to know, are we going to be using one texture or multiple textures? And do we want each side of the box to be looking the same? Or do we want each side of the box to be different? Now in our case, I'm going to be covering both ways so you can watch and decide for yourself which one you want to use. Now in preparation of the Unwrapped UVW section of this course, I thought of going over and talk a bit about the key bindings that we will be using to make it easier for us. Alright, so if you went ahead and actually downloaded my key bindings from my Dropbox, you're all set to go, but if you didn't do that, you want to go ahead and keep on watching because I'm going to be showing you what key bindings we're going to be using and changing here. Now you want to go ahead and click onto Customize, Customize User Interface. In here you want to select Key Bindings. Under Groups, you want to select Unwrap UVW and scroll down until you find the action called Stitch. Now I have bound the key Stitch to Ctrl+Q on the keyboard because it's very easy to access with the left hand, and you're going to be accessing Stitch quite often in the Unwrap UVW window. Now if you scroll further down, you can find something that is called TV Element Mode. You want to bind this to something that is really close to 1, 2, and 3 on the keyboard. I bound this to the number 4 key on the keyboard. And that's it. Alright, so let's just discuss the unwrap process right now. As I mentioned before, we're going to do two different unwraps, so the best thing would be to copy the existing model that we already have, so we do one unwrap on the first box and do another unwrap on the second box. Now also, you want to make sure that our box is going to be an editable poly. I'm not going to go into the greatest detail of what that is, but it is enabling us to do a bit more advanced stuff with the box that we have. So if you just right click on the box and go down to convert to, and then you can convert this to an editable poly. Now what you want to go ahead and do is to duplicate the existing model by holding down shift and the left mouse button and drag and pull the model in one direction. Then you want to release the left mouse button and name the model to something and press OK. Now you want to go ahead and click onto the command panel and go to the modifier tab. Go down in the modifier list and scroll down until you find Unwrap UVW. Now a window called Edit UVWs are going to pop up. If this window doesn't show up, you can go down into the command panel again and under a column called Edit UVs, click the Open UV Editor. Now a new window should pop up. Now if you look to the bottom of that, you should see that I have a little window down there with selection mode, textures and all that. It's a plugin that I have, and do not worry about it because I'm not going to be using it in this video. So let me just go ahead and remove that. Alright, so now you're left with this little window that you have no idea what to do with. So let me just expand the window and talk a bit about what this is really for and what we can do with this. So what you can see right now is that we have a little checker pattern in the middle of here, and then around that we have what I call the workspace, the grey area. And to the top here and to the right and to the bottom here we have a couple of tools we can use to increase sort of the speed of how we work. Not to worry right now, but what you're watching right now is going to probably be the hardest episode of the series in total. The unwrap part is going to be quite difficult to explain, and to grasp the concept the best way, you should probably also be looking around for other examples and other ways of how you can unwrap models in different sort of ways. So the main goal about this is going to be that you want to break apart your model and place it inside of the checker pattern box, generate a texture map for it, bring it into something like Photoshop, texture it, bring it back in, apply the texture, and then you're done. So let's now go ahead and go through each of the steps to show you how it's done. Now, if you want to make each side of the box to be different looking, then you want to go ahead and do the following things. Now, in the top where you can see File, Edit, Select, and all that, you want to click on Mapping, then Flatten Mapping, and then press OK. Now you should see that you have six small squares inside of the checker pattern. Now, these six faces represent each side of the box because the box have six faces or six sides. So what the flatten mapping really did for us was to make sure that each side of the box or each face of the box gets its own exposure inside of the checker pattern, which is good because we want each side of the box to have its own texture. So the first step is actually done now. We have made the map, it looks good, it's all inside of the checker pattern, and we can now go ahead and render it out by going into Tools and go down to the bottom and click on Render UVW Templates. Now we get a new window called Render UVs. In here you can select the width and the height of the map. Let's go with 124 by 124. And the rest of the option you can actually ignore for the moment. Now you want to click onto the Render UV Template. Now you should get a new screen, and in here you want to save the image by clicking on the top left corner where you see the save icon. You want to now save the image as a PNG or a target file. We will then in next episode take a look at how we can make a texture from the UV template and how to apply it to our model. Now for the second model that we're going to be looking at, if you actually check the generate mapping codes when you created the object or the box in our case, then you actually don't have to do anything. I'm going to be showing you in the UVW unwrapping section of how it looks, but as you can see, we do not have to do anything because it's already filling out the entire space. So what it really did was to take all the squares or the entire model and make sure that each face is filling out the entire checkerboard and making sure that each face is rotated correctly. Now this is quite a simple way of explaining the unwrap process for a very, very basic model such as a box or a rectangle. We're going to be covering a couple of more advanced models in the future, but this will be it for now. In the next episode, we will be taking a look at how we can use our newly created UV template for creating our own texture and then how to apply it to the model. I thought of ending the video by saying thank you so much for your support. Like the video if you liked it. If you enjoyed this or any of my other videos, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next episode.